Will the market go up or down? Should you lock in or float? Find out this and more with Master of the Markets.
Welcome to Master of the Markets. I'm Barry Habib at MBS Highway. This is created exclusively for Mortgage News Network. Hey, there's a new sheriff in town, and his name is Jerome Powell. We forecasted this several weeks ago, told you he was going to be the new Fed chair. And last week, certainly Donald Trump appointing him as the Fed chair. So what can you expect? A lot like Janet Yellen, with one big exception. This man has some business experience. Now, if there's a drawback on Jerome Powell, it is that he has been somewhat of a conformist. In other words, he has been pliable, and instead of standing up for his beliefs, he's kind of gone along with the crowd. He voted for QE3, although he was against it. So this is perhaps some signs that he lacks some leadership skills. I don't know. You don't want to prejudge the man. Now, on the other hand, he's been very successful business-wise. He has been known as the most wealthiest of the Fed members. And again, this is a guy that has some business experience. So I think this is a good pick. It's a very logical pick. Let's hope that he stands up for the things that he believes in. I think we'll have some good Fed leadership if that's the case. So don't expect too many changes, especially initially. I don't think I'll want to rock the boat. Now, last week, we also did get some interesting things. Housing, very strong. Rates of appreciation, as reported by Kay Schiller, very well respected, accelerating from 5.9 to 6.1% year over year. We're telling you, this housing market has a long way to go. It's going to continue to be strong. And of course, we got the big jobs report. Now, very skewed because of the storms, but overall, what's interesting in the jobs report is that we did see the unemployment rate drop. That dropped from 4.2, already low, to 4.1%. The way it dropped is very interesting. You know, it dropped because the report that it goes by, within the report, employment numbers, there are two reports. There is a business survey. There's a survey that actually makes phone calls to individuals and households, known as the household survey. So the unemployment rates derived from the household survey. And in that report, we lost almost 500,000 jobs. So how in the world did the unemployment rate drop? Well, people leaving the workforce, that jumped by 765,000. So the net of almost 300,000 people that have left the workforce means that the number of unemployed people were in a smaller pool. So the rate of unemployment dropped from 4.2 to 4.1%. So there you go. That's government math for you. Okay, so this week, it's a really quiet news week this week, but very important to watch those technical levels. Remember, we said that the 10-year Treasury would come back to 2.385. Sure enough, it did. Broke beneath it. Let's watch it stay beneath that. Watch mortgage bonds if you're on MBS Highway, which you should be. Watch that 200-day moving average on mortgage bonds. So we've been dialing it in. We set the float into the jobs report to our subscribers. We all benefited. Let's see what happens right here this week with rates. Get on MBS Highway. I think you'll really enjoy it. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.
This is Mortgage News Network.